lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, it is impossible that the blood of bulls and goats take away sins. For this reason, when Christ came into the world, he said, "Sacrifice and offering you did not desire, but a body you prepared for me, and holocausts and sin offerings you took no delight." Then I said, "As is written of me in the scroll, behold, I come to do your will, O God." First he says, "Sacrifice and offerings, holocaust and sin offerings, you neither desire nor delighted in. These are offered according to the law." Then he says, "Behold, I come to do your will." He takes away the first to establish the second. By this will, we have been consecrated through the offerings of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. I'm sorry, I read the second reading first.
That's okay.
Responsorial Psalm. Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will. Sacrifice or oblation you wish not, but ears open to obedience you gave me. Holocaust or sin offerings you sought not. Then said I, "Behold, I come."
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
In the written scroll it is prescribed for me to do your will. O my God, is my delight, and your law is within my heart.
Here I am, Lord, I want to do your will.
I announced your justice in the vast assembly. I did not restrain my lips, as you, O Lord, know.
Here I am, Lord, I want to do your will.
Your justice I kept not hid within my heart. Your faithfulness and your salvation I have spoken of. I have made no secret of your kindness and your truth in vast assembly.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
The first reading was a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord spoke to Ahaz and said, "Ask for a sign from the Lord your God. Let it be deep as the netherworld, or as high as the sky." But Ahaz answered, "I will not ask. I will not tempt the Lord." Then Isaiah said, "Listen, O house of David, it is not enough for you to weary people. Must you also weary my God? Therefore the Lord himself will give you this sign. The virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is upon my lips and within my heart, so I may worthily proclaim his holy gospel. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. Coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord. weeping this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David his father. He will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. Behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord Jesus Christ. We go, as you know, 40 days in the Lenten season. But there are a couple of days that are extraordinary, and we celebrate and we are festive during the Lenten season, such as the Feast of Saint Joseph. It is a day that the priests wear white to announce joyful celebration, and the purple color is discarded for that day. Also, today is another one of the churches stopping in the midst of Lenten penance to rejoice and to be glad. For here on March the 25th is the Annunciation. 9 months from now, so prepare yourselves, get your Christmas wrapping paper together, for in 9 months exactly will be the birth of Jesus. 9 months. I think it's irregular nowadays for women to go exactly 9 months. It's either a little sooner or a little later. But Mary, she does things perfectly. 9 months. And the angel came to her, as we have proclaimed in the gospel. And the angel announced to her, "I guess, you young women, if all of a sudden you had a man in your bedroom while you were alone, I don't think he would be so welcoming and happy that he was there. It would be very startling to you." So the first words of the angel, "Don't be afraid, Mary. Don't be afraid." And I would imagine that if there was some someone to come to do you harm, they would not announce themselves. Don't be afraid of me. That would be misunderstood, because only an angel comes to you in such a beautiful way with glad tidings and good news. Mary, you are to conceive of Emmanuel, God with us. At that moment, when Mary said yes, she conceived. She conceived by the gift of the Holy Spirit. And in that, her blood becomes the blood lifeline for Jesus, her Son, God's Son. God instructed her through the angel, fashion for me a body. And Mary said, I am your maidservant, your will be done. And so Mary fashioned a body, and her blood flowed in this body. So due to Mary's motherhood, she brought eternal life to present life in her child, who will be named Jesus. Now, during this great feast, the church allows that great sacraments that we have may be celebrated. We could have the sacrament of confirmation today. We can have the sacrament of holy orders. It can be done during the Lenten season on this, the Annunciation of the birth of Jesus. And guess what? I was ordained a priest on this day during Lent, on the Feast of the Annunciation. Today is 45 years of priesthood. Don't go, oh, it's not that bad. But it has been a great blessing and a great honor to be chosen by God, as Mary was chosen by God, to a particular vocation, a particular bringing forth the presence of the body and blood of Jesus, as does the priest in the Holy Mass. He brings forth, he fashions the body of Jesus and the blood of Christ. So today is an exceptional day for us to rejoice, and don't worry about our penance that we have taken on for Lent. We are excused today from all of the Lenten practices, because it is a day of announcement. It's a day of great joy, and you are the bearers of this good news, for you hold within you Christ Jesus, as Mary was chosen to bring in herself God, Jesus himself, Christ our Lord. So celebrate with me on this day of remembrance. And it's often curious to me how became a precious blood priest, because the readings always, this time, refers to the blood, the lifeline. And it just so happened that the clergy in my home parish were precious blood priests. St. Gaspar, our founder, was born January the 6th. And guess what? I was born January the 4th, very close to our founder. So he and I are, what would you call, Capricorns? Yes. And so we share, I, St. Gaspar, and Jesus, for he is Capricorn as well. Okay, if you would stand, please. Following the example of Mary's faith in God, let us entrust our petitions to Him. For the Church, may the Holy Spirit protect and guide us in our mission to proclaim the truth of salvation to all the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government leaders, may the Lord open their hearts to work tirelessly in protecting the dignity and sanctity of human life from conception through natural death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, may the healing consolation of Christ be upon them and make them holy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may God help us to trust always in His saving power. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they experience the mercy of God and enjoy fullness of life with Him in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And the reason why I was ordained So I wasn't even finished with the seminary yet. I still had some time, and I was a baby when I was ordained a priest. And my sister was there, and she's here today on my 45th anniversary. And let me see, you'll get to see who my sister is here. Heavenly Father, hear our prayers that we bring to you today. We ask this through your Son and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Overshadowing power of the Holy Spirit.
mercy on us.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O Sacrament.
The intentions for this morning's Mass, Father John Fiore, Ardifith, Ardith, and Ken Clausen, SCA and Religious Education students, our teachers and staff members. Let us pray. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and his name will be called Emmanuel. Confirm in our minds the mysteries of the true faith, we pray, O Lord, so that confessing that he who was conceived of the Virgin Mary is true God and true man, we may, through the suffering power of his resurrection, merit to attain eternal life and eternal joy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the Almighty God now bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Please go in peace, love, and serve the Lord.
Thanks
be to God. Eternal Father,
we offer you
the precious blood of Jesus Christ in atonement for our sins, in supplication for the souls in purgatory, and for the needs of his holy church. Glory to the blood of Jesus, now and forever.
Amen.
Have a wonderful day.
Thank you, Father.
Yes, it's supposed to snow today. Should we put the Christmas trees down?